All right, it is 7 o'clock, so we're going to go ahead and go live with this. What is up, everyone? Welcome to the stream. This week, we're going to be doing something a little bit different than working on the comic itself, because production of the comic has gotten so far ahead that showing anything now would potentially be huge spoilers for the story. So we're going to be doing something that I've actually wanted to do for a while, but never had the chance to. We're going to be revamping Ikora's character sheet. Now, I know what you're thinking, fan artists. I'm not completely, like, redoing her design. I'm simply going to be tweaking this to be a better character sheet and better reflect how I draw her now in the comics, because you can see there's a little slight differences here and there between her, how I draw her in the comics and how I draw her here. So we're going to go ahead and get started on that. First thing we'll need is to be on pencil and not pen. We're going to be on black. Now, the three basic things that this character sheet is going to have to cover is how she looks on the front, how she looks on the back, and all the small details that her outfit includes. This will include a definitive design for her backpack jetpack. So we're going to go ahead and get started by drawing a pose for her front. As you can see, I've made this quite long, so that way we have a lot of room to fit stuff. So here we go. If you have any questions, please feel free to ask. But first, I have a question for y'all. If you've read my webcomic, Project Valkyrie, which I will drop a link for real quick, or you can just access by inputting the command !comic, as I'm about to do. Just like that, you can click on that link, read through it. Tell me, what is your favorite chapter of the comic and why? That's the question for this week. And now sit back, relax, and enjoy as we begin to redesign Ikora here. So when you design a pose for a character sheet, you want it to really show off the design in its best. So what we're going to do is have Ikora kind of just... Well, she's going to just be standing here so that you can clearly see the design and everything involved in it. Glad you think so, Floof. Thank you, Floof. And that's where her extra stuff will go. Then there's her chest. When designing a character and when putting a pose down on a character sheet, you should keep their personality in mind. So with Ikora, she is going to stand kind of heroically since she is a superhero. We're going to have her foot point that way, and we're going to have it come down that way. Hey Amber, how's it going? Thank you for joining in on the stream. I don't know if you heard the question of the day that I asked earlier, but I'll just re-ask it again. Since you have read the comic, oh hello Hambone Live, how are you doing today? I do not map out the volumes first, Floof. I actually just draw the stick figure first. I draw the wireframe, and then I'll, like, add some bubbles for muscles. I don't really work as other traditional or, like, traditionally as other artists do, but... All right, thank you, Hambone, for at least tuning in. I always just kind of map out where I want everything to be, and then I'll start drawing. So, like, I know she's gonna have cuffs, so I'm gonna go ahead and draw cuffs. Spew out fully detailed character sketches in 5 minutes. Yeah, that I wish I could work that fast, honestly. It would be amazing if I could work fully detailed character sketches in 5 minutes. We'll be using her old character sheet as a reference, mainly for stuff like her height, her weight, what her body build's going to be like, and the colors especially. is that I can't translate that to digital formats in terms of speed. It is very hard to draw fast digitally, because in digital, you can get nitpicky. Now see, her head's a little bit big, so we're gonna lasso tool that, and we're going to... Oh wow, it's hard to see this keyboard in the dark. Because it is backlit, but none of the characters on it are backlit. See, now I'm different, Floof. I actually use Control-Z a lot. Just kind of have a basic face up there so we can map everything out and scale it. Thank you, Hambone. I've worked a little bit on this setup. In front of me, I have a Huion GT191 canvas drawing tablet, which you can't see on camera right now. But I also have my iMac right here, which has a 720p HD webcam in it, so it's really good for streaming. I also have these little color-changing lights and my Kitsune mask that I got at a convention a few weeks ago back here. So it's, I feel like it's really personal. Okay, her elbow is in a little bit of a bad spot, so we're gonna... There we go, we're going to cheat. And if you do have any questions about the drawing process or what I'm even doing or any part of my setup, like what equipment I use, please do not hesitate to ask. I would love to answer any and all questions. Made her head a touch too small. I have questions, but about you. Ask away. If they're not too personal, go ahead and ask away. Why did I start? Why did I start drawing, or why did I start my webcomic? Drawing? It was just something I found I enjoyed. It's about that plain and simple. I really started back in middle school. It was a lot of positive feedback when I drew, so I decided why not keep doing that? And then I discovered this whole art community online with Twitter and Amino and all of that, even though I don't really use Amino anymore, but still. I've been wanting to animate and improve my drawing for a while. I actually saw an ad on YouTube that I could help me with that. Yeah, YouTube is a great source if you are looking to learn how to draw or learn how to animate. There are plenty of art tutorial channels out there. I personally am self-taught. I have never taken a formal art class in my life. There are also some great books out there, especially if you're wanting to learn how to draw anime or manga styled. One of them that I have, I believe, is A Master Guide to Drawing Anime by Christopher Hart. He has a lot of good resources that he's written that other people actually draw for him. In order to really improve at art, what you really need to do is draw every day and intentionally draw stuff that you struggle with so that you can get better and better at it. Like for me, I struggled drawing, I struggle still drawing hands. So I've done multiple drawings where hands were the main focus and I learned how to stylize my hands. Make your legs a little bit longer. And a key thing with art, too, is your drawing muscles can get sore. So it is very important that you, one, stay hydrated, and two, stretch. You don't think that you'd have to stretch when you do this sort of thing, but it is very important to keep your muscles from tiring out. Like, you see me stretching my shoulder a lot, that's because it's sore from trying to keep tension with my pencil. So I often just kind of step back for a second and I'll stretch. One good stretch is to grab your palm, or to grab the fingers right here and push out with your palm. Just hold it for a few seconds and then flip your hand over and do it the other way so you can see it this way. I do this a lot whenever I draw to help stretch out my wrists. It also helps from keeping carpal tunnel if you use a mouse a lot, like I do with editing. It just helps to keep the muscles stretched out and relaxed. For those of you that don't know Freelancer Amber in the chat, she's actually the voice of one of the characters in my comic, Project Valkyrie, which that dub is probably premiering later this month. The first episode is already out on YouTube. Near the end of the stream, I will plug the link for that if y'all want to go watch it. It's about 4 or 5 minutes long. So if you want to tune the stream out for a few minutes and watch it, I do not mind at all. Okay, feet are always hard to draw for me, but they come in three basic shapes. You start off with the heel, go down to the bridge, and then end on the toe. And just as a little plug, I am now accepting fan art of my webcomic Project Valkyrie. If you can get it submitted by this coming Monday, which is October 7th, I will look at it and see if it can be put into the credits of the next episode of The Dub, which comes out on Tuesday. Now, Ikora normally does wear headphones to protect her ears during flight, but for this drawing, we're not going to include them because this is her like most basic vanilla design. Alright, now since we have her front pose drawn, we're going to go ahead and start on the back. That only took about 15 minutes, so we might be able to line both of these by the time stream is over. But we're going to go ahead and first thing I draw always is the head. Let's see, then we'll draw her back, kind of arching outwards. And then her hair, one of her goggles sticking off the side. Ikora does need head pats. She deserves head pats. After the crap she's been through over the last 3 months in the comic, she needs head pats. All right, now this pose will be a little bit different. We'll just have her arms kind of neutral right here. And one way to easily tell body shape is to cross from one shoulder to the opposite hip and then just kind of smooth out the shape. But it's not exactly going to work for us over there, but it will over here. Ikora's original design actually had her wear a skirt. As long as she doesn't give the darkness-induced apathy. Please explain what you mean by darkness-induced apathy. Let me look at this real quick. Darkness-induced apathy is often said. Okay. Meaningful conflict. All right. Her conflict will probably be meaningful, but this first arc, it might not end in the way that you want, but I do have a lot of big plans for the second arc. Now let's see, did my music stop, or if no, it's just a long outro. Searching for a beach vacation? Find it. I'm not searching for a beach vacation, Verbo. Now on her back, in her original design, Ikora had a plate that her backpack would attach to, right? But for this, for her actual backpack, I'll allow it, Nova. I'll permit that term. So on her original, she has this plate that the backpack attaches to, because I wanted her to kind of call it psychopathically, or not psychopathically, telekinetically, through like a chip in the back of her neck or something. But for her in-comic design, she actually just wears the pack on her back, and the wings that come out of it are actually, like, they actually appear out of it. So she's just going to have the pack on her back for this. I still struggle with drawing people from behind. Just when something is so dark and edgy that instead of causing the audience to sympathize with the character or story, it just causes them to not care about what happens. Okay. Because I don't want it to be, I don't want it to... When I do dark and edgy stuff in Project Valkyrie, I don't want to do it just for the sake of being edgy. I want it to have a purpose. Like how Ikra has to deal with being homeless. She was an orphan that grew up out of the system, so she has a reason for kind of having a problem with getting friends or fitting in with people, because not many people grow up homeless. Got back from after school. I recently signed up for it and it was pretty cool. Nice. Glad you enjoy it, Nova. Her knees are about there and her feet are here-ish. So there are her thighs. I'm gonna build out the form. I think I actually drew her a bit too high. Actually, I drew her too small. Wow. She's small. How does one go about a model sheet? That is exactly what I'm doing tonight. So firstly, I came up with how my character looks from the front. That is the easiest way to go about it, is to decide how are they going to look when they're looking at somebody. Then you normally go for the back, and then the sides, and then all the small details that like cosplayers would appreciate. Like the way they did Yang's Volume 7 turnaround. It has a view from the front, the side, the back, but it also has small details like how she wears her sunglasses on her head or clipped on her shirt. Ikra's is going to have, well, at least I plan on hers having how she looks when she wears her goggles, what she looks like with her white jacket off, the pattern on the side of her boots that goes down. So a little bit of just how everything on them looks. I might have drawn her entire upper torso a bit too small. Yeah, that's a little better. Okay. Thank you. I try to draw kind of fast, but as you can see, not really fast enough. I rarely finish what I plan on starting on a stream in an hour, in the hour that I stream. Now, Ikra is a little bit muscular, but her clothes are kind of loose fitting, so it kind of hides that. Good to have you back, Amber. How are you? Her jacket flares out a bit and then comes back. I think maybe her waist is a little too high now. Yeah, normally you don't see the back of Ikora's jacket because she has her wings out, but you need to be aware of what it looks like. And a few people I know have asked, what are these little pockets for? And I'll say that they're for ammo, but they're really for cosplayers to put their stuff in. Why not stream longer? Because this is actually for a school project, Nova. And on the outline for that project, I stated that I would stream for an hour. I also don't have much time because midterms are coming up. So there's her shorts. Generally come up with a pose and draw the front, side, back, other side view of the character, then add extra details later. Yeah, normally you do more than one side view, but with Ikora, her outfit is pretty generic, so I'm just going to draw the pattern on her sleeve, and I think that would be good enough. Coming up here in a couple minutes, we're going to hit the 30-minute mark, meaning it will be time for our water break. Feel free to take that time. It'll be about a minute. Take that time to get some water, stretch. Boots flare out at the top a bit. And she has back pockets. Alrighty, and with that done, I think I'm gonna go ahead and take a water break real quick. Don't forget to stay hydrated, everybody. I'll be right back in just a minute. Yeah, since this is for a school project, Nova, I can't allow any sort of profanity in chat. I'm sorry. But if you could clean up your question, I'm sure we will answer it after our water break, which I will take right now. So y'all don't go anywhere. I will be right back. Stay hydrated. Thank you. Okay, and we are back. Sorry about that. Okay, so now that we have Ikra's basic pose done, I think it's time we go ahead and line art this part of the character sheet. So we're going to lower the opacity of this layer, make a new one, change it to a pen. Once again, question of the week, what is your favorite chapter of Project Valkyrie and why? And to remind everybody, my comic is, if you just type exclamation point comic, you can access the link at any time. The premiere of the second episode of the dub is going out on Tuesday, more than likely at 11 a.m. Now we are going to add a little bit more detail. Thank you for hosting, Powergeist! Thank you so much for hosting. I'll be live for another 30 minutes or so here. I'm struggling drawing this eyelash. Microphone keeps getting in the way. But I also want to talk to you guys, so we have a bit of a moral dilemma here. She looks too not excited. So we're going to raise it up in the middle and drop it down on the sides. What seems better for a cool female character, a cropped varsity jacket or a leather jacket? That depends on their personality. Are they more aggressive or are they more, like, pacifist? Foxtail and fox ears, of course. Of course, that's how you make all popular anime characters, right? You add the tails and ears of an animal, and suddenly, they're wife material. Or at least according to the internet. The internet and DeviantArt. I don't like how I drew this eye. I don't like it. I don't like it one bit. I think it needs to be a bit more big round. Actually, how I draw eyes, but with less eyelash. Yeah, you draw yours with a lot of eyelash. It's a neat artistic style, but I personally like to keep them under control and keep the focus on the middle of the eye, because that's the part everybody looks at. Again, Floof, that's a stylistic choice more than anything. Hey, Joji! Thanks for tuning in! Just posted an example on Discord. By the way, everyone, before I forget, we do have an official Project Valkyrie Discord. Ooh, I really like that, Floof. I like the red color scheme of it. Though, that's not, like, a ridiculous amount of eyelash. I actually really like that. Let me find the invite link. Don't forget that we have an official Discord. And I'll post the link in chat real quick. Remember, we have an official Discord that you can join. We post fan art there all the time. We have all sorts of fun talks there. Now you'll notice with this eye, you don't make it shorter, you just make it thinner this way, not this way. I used to do that, and now I just don't because it used to look awful. Because unless you're seriously stylizing something, eyes don't get smaller vertically as they get further away from you, they get smaller horizontally as they get away from you. I did forget one little thing. It's contagious. Tell me, do you feel it too? This dumb magician tricking me to loving you. Turning pages, looking for something new. But the rain is stopping me from pulling through. They're a little bit too far apart. I want some fried dumplings too, Nova. I could go for some gyoza, or I could actually really go for some good ramen right now. I didn't have that big of a dinner. And I don't mean like the stuff you put in the microwave. I mean like real ramen, like sliced pork and soy sauce and soft-boiled egg and real thick noodles. With rice, and not with rice, just ramen. McCurry. I've actually never had curry. I know, shocking, but I've never had it. You've had curry in Japan? Lucky! Have you tried those red bean buns? Those hit different. Bro, I'll tell you what hits different is when you're hungry, but you have no food and no money. If you keep wondering why I select the wrong tool, it's because everything on this keyboard is backlit except for the characters themselves. So I keep hitting O instead of P on accident. Now the key thing with fabric around joints like this is you want to wrinkle it up and kind of draw it bunching up around here. The brown one, the Japanese one. Look, all I know and all I can tell you about is that tonkatsu ramen is one of the greatest foods on this planet. Like, no matter what, if you mention we are having tonkatsu, I will cherish that forever. We've got a good ramen place about 30 minutes south of here. That's delicious. Now, if you're wondering why her jacket is so thick, it's actually kind of a parka. So it's a little bit thicker than her normal body would be, because it's got all the fluffy stuff inside of it. Alright, now with hands, you see her palm hits right here, so it goes up a little bit, but her fingers wrap around, so we're gonna draw them doing that, and then her pinky probably resting on top of this thing. There's the top of her shorts, top of her belt, and then the top of her buckle. And we cannot forget the essential belly button. Next week, I do hope to stream for longer. Oh god, add the thumb back. Is that better? Cosplay storage stuff. And that is something I tell people that you should prioritize a lot in your character designs. Aw, thanks, Floof. I've been really trying to improve on drawing hands. So, yeah, that looks bad. Draw the base of the hand as a square block. I would if this was not the line art layer. And at this point, that backhand can be a silhouette. I am super excited for chapter 10 of this comic to come out on Tuesday, along with the episode 2 dub. I just got the vocal mix done for episode 3, and it sounds really good. And it has a lot of people in it. It's got Amber in it, it's got my friend Lauren, my friend Amin, it has Kaito Dan in it and everything. And 3 cylinders for each finger. See, I normally don't, like, build my hands like that. I just kind of draw what looks right. Now she has trim around the top of her boot.
Yo.
All right, we've got about 5 or 10 minutes left before I have to cut it off for the night because I have a lot of homework that needs doing. So I'm probably just going to line her other leg and then call it for tonight because I do have a ton of stuff that I need to do. I didn't taper in quite right. Going to do that. Got time for a little bit more. We can start on flat colors if we really wanted to. You know what? We're gonna go ahead and flat color this thing before I shut it off for the night. Maybe add some details in. Let's undo that. Flat color this thing. So When it comes to flat colors, I always put everything in its own little group. So like skin is going to go in one group. And you'll notice on her original character sheet, her skin is actually a little bit more pale than how I like to do it now. So we're going to crank up the saturation a bit. Turn off the sketch layer. This is why you make sure you close off your line art. And then included in the skin, I always include the mouth. Now for her clothes. Her clothes are fairly easy, since most of them are white, like the clouds. And you'll notice I did a little bit of a trick here so I could actually shade this. I didn't make it pure white. I cheated and made it a little bit gray. But we're going to make these stark white now. And for her goggles, I'm not sure if I want to keep using this shade. That's really light. I want it to be a bit darker. Now for the rest, we're going to actually kind of use her old scheme here and tame that color. We're actually going to make it a little bit lighter. We're actually going to take it out of red and make it more blue. We're gonna make her shorts a different shade than her belt, which is gonna be the same shade as her gloves and the bags on the side. And normally I color over the line art inside, that way there isn't any white that shows through. Now for the rest of her clothes are a sort of teal glowing strip, like an LED strip almost. So not quite that blue anymore. You can notice on here it's actually about the same color. So we're actually just going to use this color. Alright, and usually the next layer I do up from her clothes is her hair. Not her hair, her hair. We'll just make this stream run a little bit long and That way I can actually finish this up. Now you'll notice her hair here, it's a fairly like neutral purple. It's not very, it doesn't pop that much. We want it to pop a little more, so I'm gonna make it brighter. And what a difference. I actually want her goggles to be a lighter gray, like a reflective silvery gray. There we go. All right, and for the last little bit of her design that we're gonna do tonight, we're gonna do her eyes. Now her eyes are sky blue. Let's make a folder for it. I always start off drawing the whites. I believe the medical term for the white part of the eye is the sclera. Now we're actually gonna make her eyes. You'll notice in her original art, her eyes are a more pale blue. And I drew them differently than I do now with way smaller pupils. So we're actually going to increase the saturation a bit on her eye and make them a brighter, more noticeable blue, closer to her, the rest of her design. All right, and with that, I think I'm gonna call it for the stream tonight. Thank you all so much for tuning in. This is one of the biggest turnouts I've had for one of my streams lately. I let it run a bit long, but I'm glad that I did so that we could go ahead and finish that out. Thank you once again for tuning in. You can find me on, well, obviously Twitch, but also Twitter. I accidentally hit caps lock. Hold up. You can find me on Twitter right there. You can read my comic here. And you can support me on Patreon. I believe I have that set up. Do I? No, I don't. Okay, I'll just grab the link. You can support me on Patreon right here. If you wish to have your name in the back of all the chapters of my comic, or if you would like early access to every chapter, because it is going out for the public on Tuesday, but it is going out for patrons on Saturday, so hopefully you would consider supporting me for as little as $1 a month. So please keep that in mind. Thank you all for watching, and I hope y'all have an excellent rest of your week. Bye!